Alrighty, now it's time for Friday Night Love. Guys, why do we have shoes on here for Friday Night Love?
It's a very good question, Jesse. We've done a bit of independent research. We found that there's a lot of interest in being able to tell a man by his shoes online. We figured we'd do our own kind of research, summed up by these lists.
Yep.
Okay.
Right,
apart from his size.
Apart from his size, of course, Jesse. Shoe arches, that's a big one, all right? Shoe arches, how much the shoe arches. If he's got flat feet, you don't want that. How's he meant to run away if something happened?
That's right. Golf shoes. If a guy's wearing golf shoes, I mean, he doesn't even play a real sport, how's he going to be in a real relationship?
Yep, shiny shoes. If you can see yourself in them, you can see yourself in his basement. Serial killer.
High heels. If a guy's wearing high heel shoes, this could actually be a good thing because he's willing to be a bit adventurous, try new things. Either that or he could just be a cross-dresser.
So, if you play golf, stay away from him, but if he wears high heels, he's a keeper.
Yes.
That's what we reckon. 50-50.
Rubber boots. I'd bet my soul that he's a serial killer. Stay away. Definitely.
Ugg boots. More like ugly boots.
Yes. All right. Crocodile skin. If he's willing to skin an animal, he's willing to skin you. Serial killer.
Crocs. If he's wearing Crocs, then you need to.
You guys see
serial
killers everywhere.
We do. Well, they're really common.
Have you seen Crocs? Have you seen how bad they are?
Yeah, actually, you're right.
Yeah. In that case, if he's wearing Crocs, you need to be a serial killer and do the world a favour.
Steel caps. You know, what's he expecting to happen on a
day? One of these.
Some kind of fight?
Well, he could just be a bricky or something.
No, maybe.
I mean, that's health and safety.
He lays bricks.
Well, maybe.
Or he's a serial killer.
What's the final one? Not wearing shoes. This is where me and Dan and I disagree. We feel, you know, he's just a genuine person. Dan thinks serial killer, which I think is a bit, you know, over-assessing.
What about thongs?
There's a lot of people.
If you wear thongs, let's just hope she's got low standards, I guess.
What about these? What about standard Converse?
Well, they're lovely. I'm a Converse man.
Thank you. There you go.
You brought some shoes in.
I'm not a serial killer, ladies.
Have a look at the shoes we got down here.
We brought some shoes. Dan brought some clown shoes.
They're actually just my regular shoes, Colin.
Congratulations.
Alrighty, well, thanks for coming on the show, guys. It was very enlightening. Now I can tell what guys to stay away from, you know, what guys are going to put me in their basement. Alright, awesome. Thanks for coming on the show, guys. Now, Aaron and Rach are roving around in the beer garden.
Okay, welcome back to the beer garden. Now, I've looked high and low for people that are over stuff, and I'm now here with Anna. How you doing, Anna?
Not too bad.
And Joanna. How you doing, Joanna?
Not too bad.
Now, we were talking a little bit off camera before, and you guys were telling me about what you're sick of. What are you sick of, Anna?
Absolutely retarded customers. People who are rude to the people who try and serve them.
I can't stand them. What else are you sick of?
Emos. Don't get me started on emos.
Don't get me started on emos. They managed to grow the hair and then they abuse it. That hurts me.
Not just that, the tight pants. I mean, you know, they're never going to reproduce, procreate, whatever.
Well, not well, not healthy. And what about those little legging things that aren't really leggings and they're not really pants? What are they?
Instead of pants, it's a case of, honey, I don't want to see your vag. I'm sorry, I do not want to see your bits.
That means, the camel toe. You don't like the camel toe?
Oh, no.
It depends on, some people look good.
Some of them, yes, but it's very rare.
Very rare.
The city on a Friday, no. Life.
Doesn't look good on a male, does it?
I've seen a few of those too.
So there you go. We're sick of angry customers and people that just don't realise when clothes are getting too small for them.
Oh, yes.
So I'm going to stay up here with Anna and Joanna, and we're going to find out exactly what else we don't like about what is out there. And we're going to cross back to you, Jesse, and find out what you don't like.
Thank you, Aaron. Now joining us on the couch is our very good friend, Steph.
Hey, Steph.
For Culture Vulture.
How are you guys?
Good. What'd you get up to for this week?
This week I went to PECA, which is the Perth Institute for Contemporary Arts, and I saw an exhibition called The Love of Diagrams.
A whole lot of PowerPoint.
Love diagrams.
There was no PowerPoint, actually.
What?
No, and no Venn diagrams. Basically what
graphs?
Do... Well, sort of. They kind of, they take diagrams and turn them into an art form, so the whole idea of the thing is to, like, make it
and they've got like electronics and stuff.
Army. Yeah,
you can touch them as well.
Yeah, there was this setup where it was basically a diagram, but you can touch it and it makes sounds. And there's one part that you can touch it and it actually picks up radio stations.
Cool. Wow.
Yeah, so it uses your body as an antenna.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
Wicked.
No, and it doesn't make your hair stand up, which is all very nice.
Well, that'd be quite cool, actually.
Yeah.
That'd be a good little science.
It's a very interesting and unusual idea. Where did this come from?
Well, it's sort of like the idea of it is it's a concept from the 60s. And what it's supposed to be is mixing the mathematical side with the arty side, so it's sort of like the two sides of the brain and mixing like opposing ideas.
Like painting a painting with a calculator.
Yes, kind
boobs.
Of.
Boobs. Was that there?
It wasn't. It should have been. I'll be complaining to them next week on your behalf.
Yeah, thank you. Please do.
Just for you. But no, there's a lot of interesting stuff. Like there's sculptures. Like there's a one made out of polystyrene. Okay. And then there's one that's kind of, it looks like a shiny kind of rock thing, but they've made that. And then,
oh, they've shinied up a rock.
Yeah, they've shinied up a rock. God. It's way cooler than I'm making it sound.
Yeah.
Well, you have to go check out to see it.
Zip off to
how long is it? Do you know how long the exhibition's going
it's
for?
It's on to the 24th of October, but I'm fairly sure it's being extended. So if you check the Pika website, and they also have an amazing website that has everything that's coming up. They have a resident artist at the moment, so there's a lot of exciting stuff happening. So check out the website. That's the best place for info.
Oh, wicked. Okay. So go see Love of Diagrams. Now, our personality this week is a very, very special guy. He's out in the beer garden with Rach.
Thanks, guys. Well, I'm standing in the beer garden with Ash Barock, our personality for this week. You've just come back from London town. Welcome back. What were you doing over there? Something to do with visual arts for the last 2 years?
I've been over there. I was over there. I got back a year ago, but I've just went back and performed at Glastonbury doing some performance and seeing my brother. He was in the US, though.
Right, so you've been doing some exciting things over there and even more exciting things now you've got back. What have you been doing? I hear there's some great night events, like some dark kind of secret magic entertainment.
Absolutely, yeah. I've got Closet Cabaret coming up, which is at the Bakery. That's on the 27th of October. And Barbiturate, which is actually at the Rosemount here on the 16th.
Excellent. So the good old Rosemount will be hosting that one. And I've got to ask you, we always ask our personalities, what do you love about Perth? You spent 2 years in London. What did you miss most about Perth, apart from friends and family?
Oh, apart from friends and family, the weather, everybody says. Of course, they always say the weather. But just the freedom. It's such a beautiful, easy life, which I don't take for granted, of course. But yeah, I guess the weather. I love the ocean, so I find myself really claustrophobic not being near the water.
Well, you've got a very ocean kind of glamour styled outfit today. And where do you go to eat?
Where do I go to eat? Where do I go to eat? I go to Sweet Java, which is like Indonesian food, and also like all over the place, I guess. Yeah, lots of pubs and stuff. So,
well, thanks for being our personality this week. So you can check him out. We'll have all the details on our website. Thanks, guys. Back to you.
Thanks, Rach. That was a special guest, Ash.
Indeed. And now we have a very special guest.
We do.
On our show for our music review, my granny, Margaret. How are you going,
Margaret?
Granny?
I'm doing very well, thank you. What's
your
name?
Jessie. You're nervous, aren't you? Alrighty, so today I asked you to watch a few video clips. So our first video clip is Kesha. Kesha, the blonde girl. The blonde girl. For the song Take It Off. Here she is. So we're gonna give him some scores. So score out of 5 for look. What did you think, Granny?
I thought she was lovely. I enjoyed that clip.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, a score out of 5?
5 for her.
Five out of 5 for look.
She is good. No one knew who she was last year. And then she just became huge.
And danceability, a score for that.
Well, yes, I jigged.
Had a bit of a jive.
Did you?
Bit of a jig along, yes.
Oh, fantastic. All right, now our next person, John Mayer. Do you know John Mayer, Granny?
Oh, yes.
Oh, he's a bit of a hunk.
You like him?
I thought he was very nice.
Yeah, and he score is. Out of 5 for look?
Oh, definitely 5.
5? Here he is. And a score out of 5 for danceability. What do you reckon?
It's about 4.5.
Oh, yeah, you could boogie a little bit.
Yes, just a slow one.
It's romantic music.
Maybe a dance with a partner, maybe.
Yes.
Lovely.
That sounds very nice.
I love his voice, though. He has the most beautiful voice.
Yes, yeah.
Indeed. All right, now our last person, Shakira.
She was number 3 as far as I was concerned.
Yep, she's number 3, yeah.
She sings the song Waka Waka,
yes.
Which was the anthem for the FIFA World Cup this year.
Oh, was it? Oh, yeah. Right. Okay.
So, for look, what was the score?
It's about... that one. Oh, no, that was a good one.
Ah!
No, it was the other one.
Kesha wasn't very good.
Oh, yes. No, I really liked her. Yeah. Yes.
Oh, that's
five
good.
For her.
Five and for dance ability?
Yes, definitely five. But the other one was more four.
Yeah.
Four? Yeah, less.
I thought that was sort of
she's
rather,
a bit trashier then.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, fantastic. Well, thanks for coming on the show, Granny.
Oh, my
and doing our music review for us. And you'll have to bring in some chocolate cake for us next
time.
Oh,
I'll do that.
Yes. Thanks, Granny.
Now let's check out the Rovers and say goodbye.
Welcome back to the beer garden here at the Rosemount. Rach, I learnt a lot tonight. I learnt a couple of words I didn't even know existed.
Like?
Vag, apparently. Well, I knew it existed, but I didn't know people could say it.
Oh, you have so much to learn.
Apparently, tight pants are out.
Oh, God, well, I've done the wrong thing tonight then.
You have? And what did you learn?
A lot of people are sick of a lot of things this week. Our government, a whole heap of different things, work, and just some things, people in their life.
Guarantee the Prime Minister came up again.
Yeah, a lot of people don't like that red-headed lady that we've got. But anyway, what we are not sick of is seeing your faces down here at the Rosemount in the beer garden so we can have a talk to you.
And find out exactly how you feel about what's going on in Perth.
That's it. So get down to the Rosemount every Friday night. We'd love to have a chat to you.
And if you bump into our Prime Minister, make sure you say hello to her and don't wear tight pants. That wouldn't be good in a ringer.
No, I don't want to see Julie Gillard with a camel toe.
Okay, that's us. We're done. And I'm going to work on Rachel and find out if we can find any tight pants.
Okay, Aaron.
See ya.
Thanks, guys. Now that's it for us this evening.
That's all for tonight. Thank you very much to the Rosemount for having us.
And good luck to all the bands in the Emergenza competition. I've had a fantastic show. We've had some awesome guests.
We have.
We had Granny on the show. That was a lot of fun. What have we got on next week?
Next week, I got to check out West Side Story, so we'll take a look at that. I know, get excited, Jessie.
West Side Story? And I feel pretty. Oh, so pretty. I shouldn't know that song, should I?
And Friday Night Love Boys, I think they'll be doing some pole dancing.
Wow.
Yeah.
Maybe don't tune in next week.
Or maybe they'll be watching some pole dancing. I don't know.
That'll be definitely something to watch.
If you guys want to contact us with any suggestions or feedback, you can email us at fnl@wtvperth.com.au.
Yeah, you got the email right.
I always get it right.
Yeah, I never get it right. All right, that's it for us this evening. Here is Kesha with Take It Off, which my granny thinks is trashy. Don't know why.